Time to talk about the politics of unforgiveness. A few weeks ago, the longtime DeForest police chief resigned with a severance package because of a video he had made 10 years before. He mocked some African-American men, well-dressed men, going into a steak and shake. He used the stereotypical urban black voice, mocking them. Well, it appeared years later, and he apologized for it, said it was stupid and so forth, turned himself in, but it wasn't enough, and they agreed to let him go, unacceptable behavior as it was. So he had a severance package, but he was recently rehired as a part-time patrol officer in the town of Madison by the town of Madison police. Since then, the Madison City Council has weighed in, strongly recommending the town of Madison rescind its offer to hire the former chief for part-time patrol work. Now, aside from this video, which was in poor taste and ill-advised, we don't know what the chief did wrong in his years as a cop or his years as a chief. And this idea of a second chance, which the town of Madison said they believed in, give this guy a second chance. Well, the Madison City Council said no, he should get a second chance in life, but not as a police officer. So now we have this situation where you can only make the same mistake once, if that's the time you made it. This idea that you can't be forgiven for past sins is an interesting dynamic. Have you committed any sins in your life? He among you who is without sin should cast the first stone. All I'm saying is, if a person apologizes repeatedly, shows remorse repeatedly, embarrasses himself and apologizes for it, at what point do we say, okay, let's move on? Or do we say you could never recover for a few seconds of bad decision-making over 10 years ago? It's the politics of unforgiveness. And if we don't forgive each other for anything we did wrong in the past, then we can never get along and go forward in the future on anything. My 2 cents. My 2 minutes are brought to you by Edge Construction and Capital Consultants. Bill McCoshin, a lobbyist who worked for Tommy, who knows how to get things done downtown. We can argue about this and more next time on 2 Minutes with Mitch.